By now, you already know how to use locality flags upon node startup to specify where nodes are physically located. Now we'll see how to use these designations to address latency in a distributed cluster by geopartitioning a table based on physical location. I alluded to this in a previous lesson, that one of the primary causes of write latency in a distributed cluster is the time it takes to reach consensus when replicas are physically far apart, simply due to speed of light latency. Localities can be used to keep relevant data close to the application and close together to minimize this effect. CockroachDB allows you to define table partitions, which gives you row-level control of how and where your data is stored. Geo-partitioning enables you to reduce latency and costs and can assist in meeting regulatory requirements for your data. Let's see how to control a table's replica distribution. As you can see, I already have a 9-node cluster running in 3 regions, US East, US Central, and US West. I've enabled an enterprise license on it since geopartitioning a table is an enterprise feature, and I've already imported some of the mover dataset onto the cluster. Let's check where the replicas of the vehicle table are located. In the replica localities column, we can see that the table has 1 replica in each locality. In a real deployment, having your replicas this far apart would mean that writes would need a round trip across the country to get written and acknowledged, causing high read and write latencies even if the cluster wasn't under load. The most effective technique for improving speed of light latency is to geopartition the data and bring those replicas close together. In essence, this means dividing data by location and pinning that data to nodes that are physically close to where the data is accessed. I'll open the SQL shell and partition the vehicles table by city. I didn't create any secondary indexes on the movers tables. However, if I had, it would be important to do the same to those. At this point, we can use replication zones to require that the city data be stored on specific nodes based on locality. We're going to pin New York and Boston to the US East region. Washington, D.C. will be pinned to the US Central. And I'll pin Seattle, Los Angeles, and San Francisco data to the US West. Over the next couple of minutes, the replicas will migrate to where they belong. To see how CockroachDB rebalances, use the show ranges statement on the vehicles table. We can see that after geopartitioning, all replicas for New York and Boston are in US East, replicas for Washington DC are in US Central, and the others are all located in US West. As a result, writes will be much faster because all replicas for the region are now co-located. To geopartition the rest of the dataset, I would repeat these steps for the other tables. We covered why latencies can occur when nodes are far apart, how to geopartition your tables, and how to control how and where your data is stored. This lesson only covered one use case for localities. There are many other ways to use locality and replication zones to reduce network latency in geo-distributed clusters. We've outlined some examples in our topology patterns docs, which is linked in the video description. Keep all of this in mind as you build out your distributed cluster.